Nice and easy. Of course, beautiful vibes of Tonics, Slick Stewart and Roger coming in right there with an amazing song. It's a Friday vibe morning, and we're telling you that you can as well catch the show live on Facebook as well as Twitter, where we happen to be live and direct. And of course, being a Friday, DJ Bell is already standing it up on the ones and twos, courtesy of Gong DJ Academy. And in case you want to get in touch with us regarding our conversation, this particular part of the show, yes, it will be very simple. All you need to do is head over to Urban Television and at Urban TV Uganda, that is Facebook and Twitter, use the hashtag Urban Today. You can tag at DJ Bellu, at Tina Fierce One, as well as at Aina Dasha, and the main man himself, that is going to be giving us some more reasons as to why he has done more musical capellas than anyone I have ever met in the country. He goes by the names of Dumba. Dumba, what's up?
Yeah, I'm chill, I'm chill.
You alright?
Yeah, I'm good.
Let me shake your hand.
Man.
Like, he's so calm and so together. By the way, amongst all the covers that you've done in the car, I think my favorite was the Navi one.
The Navi?
Who ever thought you could spit some bars, son? you've not watched that one?
No, I've not watched that one.
I need to watch it word for word. I was like, go MC, go! Damn.
Yeah.
How much time do you dedicate to learn the lyrics to this particular song?
It depends. When a song is really nice, and when it feel like it has the vibe that I like, it's gonna take me 2 hours.
Oh snap.
Yeah, but if like I'm to support somebody and I don't have the vibe, but like I really need to support this person,
yeah,
it can take me 2 days.
Let me ask, when did you birth this concept of I'll go sit in my car, turn my phone camera on, and just love on a song?
Yeah, because where I live is far away from home, we don't really listen to music back home. So, but when social media, you know, came out, then I could watch, you know, more videos on YouTube, and then now I felt like I'm close to home.
Okay.
And then I was a DJ in Canada, and I would DJ in different places, and then now because I had started listening to the music back home, I used to want to play those songs in the crowd over there.
But they don't understand.
They just go sit.
So you thought of something that will make the Ugandan crowd feel appreciated.
Exactly.
Ooh, wow,
and then that's how I started it. And then there is also like things that started when Slay Queens come on, and you know they kind of like, you know, lip sync on a song.
This is how they be like. Yeah.
Let's talk about, you know, the first time you posted your first video. What was your first video that you did?
I don't remember.
You don't remember?
But I remember the first video that got attention.
That went viral.
Got attention. Mm. It didn't get viral, but it got attention. Yeah. It was Omukwano Gwo by Vinka.
Okay.
Yeah, because I follow all artists here. I follow everybody here. Mm. And then I saw they had a number, and then they wanted people to send their challenges on that number.
Okay.
And then I was like, but you know what? I think I can change. I can also do that. Do it and then send my challenges. But I knew what I was doing was better than what I see those girls do.
Okay. Okay.
So I made a video and then I sent it to the number. And then it was not Vinka herself.
Mm-hmm.
It was a guy running the social media platform of Vinka.
Yeah.
And then when he saw the video, was like, wow, this is so great.
Mm-hmm.
And then I think and he told me, he was like, I'm going to post it in the morning. And then when he posted it, it got a lot of comments and a lot of views. But of course, because most of the times I kind of like do act like a girl, so guys don't like that.
Mm. They're like, but really?
Why do you do that though?
It's fun.
I want to attract the girls.
Okay.
Because if you're doing any business and you don't have women, you're not in business.
Okay. Yell them sugar. Yeah, he knows what pays the bills.
Yeah, that's why I have a bandana that is pink. When I came in, the lady that was seated here, she said, "Oh, I like the color." That's not only her. A lot of female, they like this color.
Okay.
And then there is a way I turn it, and it looks like a flower, and then it makes them, you know, makes.
Let's talk about your selection of songs. Yeah. Before, you know, you sit in your car, before you take 2 hours to rehearse a song and get to know the lines, you know, are there some of the things you put into consideration? Like, you know, let me do a Vinka today, tomorrow let me do a Cindy, tomorrow
is
let
it
me
a
do.
Mood or do you?
What triggers you to choose a particular song?
I think that's one of the things people don't know, and then that's the factor that makes me outstand, because mm-hmm. I choose the right song. I've been a big DJ for a long time. Like, I can't say big, but like, I've been a DJ for a long time. So I know which song people are going to like. Okay. A DJ is not supposed to play a song
that he likes.
He plays the song that people will like. So I've been doing this for a long time that I have become people, one person that has a lot of people in mm-hmm, one person. Mm-hmm. So every time I hear a song, mm-hmm. I would just know right away, it's like, because that's what I do, that's what I'm good at, like, that's the song people are gonna like.
Okay. And then that's mm-hmm. the one you jump on.
Yeah, exactly.
Which one do you think you're going to do next week?
I just did, next week?
Okay, this week.
No, what's your latest right now?
I haven't posted it, but I did Win in Waji.
Which one?
In the morning. It's called Django.
Django, the new one.
Yeah, that's what I did. Mm, mm. And I'm pretty sure, unless I performed bad, unless my performance was not good, but I'm pretty sure it's one of those.
Let's talk about the setting in which you do the video, and the car, and you know, you're playing. How did it occur to you that would be the best setting you could have for that particular moment?
Yeah, because if you follow me on Instagram mm-hmm. and then you start from down, mm-hmm. you'll see that most of the videos were not in the car. We're outside of the car.
Exactly. Yes.
Yeah. Mm. But and then I started using the car. Then because I you know, when you do something for a long time, mm-hmm. you gain experience.
Yeah.
So I said I learned that the windshield of a car, mm-hmm. it gives me a lot of light that comes in my face, mm-hmm. and then the confined space in the car,
like,
makes the sound, you know, sound clear.
You're sound boxing, basically.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So if you can imagine, if I was in a pitch, mm-hmm. in a football pitch, mm-hmm. yeah. which kind of sound would come out?
True.
But like the confined space of the car, mm-hmm. and then the big windshield like in front of me, mm-hmm. like you have a lot of lights in the studio.
Okay.
That's my studio. Daytime, that's when I shoot. Like, I have enough light.
Okay.
So people are gonna complain, mm-hmm. but I know when you're looking at me.
And it's fun to watch. It's fun
yeah, exactly.
Let's talk about the fact that, you know, you have this huge following, and every time you do a cover of a song, it goes viral.
We're
people
waiting.
Sharing. Mm-hmm. I mean, we got to see your videos all the way from wherever you are, and mm-hmm. here you are in studio with us. Do you ever feel appreciated by these artists? Like, do you have a moment where some artists get in touch with you and they're like, you know what, Dumba, man, thanks for what you did with my song. It has gotten more mileage. It has done this. Or, you know, it's just something that just goes off the table.
Yeah, now, mm-hmm. now, because I have made that name, now they have to, mm-hmm. even if you don't want.
Okay. They have to.
Yeah, I can also feel an artist that really, I just forced him to say thank you.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
But like, yeah, I just forced him to say thank you because everybody's saying thank you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Like, I can make a song that nobody knows, and then I make you a star.
Uh-huh, yeah.
Like it's said, uh-huh. Victor Cruz, when I did A Love Legend,
yeah.
it went viral because of me.
Yeah.
When I did Dina Rukoti, Amagoba, like it went viral because of me.
Mm-hmm.
People know the song because I did it.
Mm-hmm.
So now you can be a big star and I'm not on your song, and then people are like, ah, Dumba wati yaru kwa zeti silu lundi.
Tujide.
Yeah.
Dumba, you know? Have you thought about singing? Like actual singing, you go to studio and you release a song or two or three?
It was my dream when I was still a kid.
Mm. Oh yeah.
Yeah, it was my dream. But because of changing places, you know, living here in Uganda, and then going to Rwanda, from Rwanda going to Canada, and then the industry that I really wanted was the African industry. And then when I was in Rwanda, I was like, you know what? I need something that can, you know, because I'm half Rwandese and half Ugandan, I need something that can just spicy, like I don't do everything like the Ugandan or Rwandese. Both of it, but I went in Canada, and then in Canada you can imagine that I can't change the idea to say, oh, now I want to be Celine Dion.
You could be on Celine Dion, you know.
I can't,
the black man version of Celine Dion. Just think about it for a second.
Because the hustle is, you know, the hustle, because when I went there, I was like 19 years old.
Mm-hmm.
So you start to hustle. My mom was a sickly woman, and then she was the one taking care of us.
Yeah.
So when we got there, we were supposed to right away become responsible.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Even when I got in Canada, like first year, when I was 20, 21, when 22, I got married.
Okay.
And then you can imagine, like, at 22 getting married, I didn't even know what was happening. Mm-hmm. But I could not sing. You can imagine I could.
No, what's going on?
Yeah.
Understanding that you've been away for a couple of years, yes. I mean, you're a star now, you know, you have girls liking you. Between me and you, Mantula,
we like it.
How many girls do you have sliding in your DM and on a day?
I've had people say something a lot about his eyes, like, ooh, child, them eyes.
It's okay if you really want to be the one to say it. It's
no,
fine.
He has beautiful eyes. Ah, and thank then there's you. A way see, he pops them, because I have big eyes too.
Ah, done deal.
To tell the truth, I'm not going to lie. There is a lot of girls.
Ooh, in your DM. Yeah.
Not only in my DM.
Can you make him your friend? Because right now he just wants to be your wingman. He's like, ah, what about where is it?
Not don't only in my DM, mm. I have like a WhatsApp group that...
Only women?
Yeah.
Hey! I want to be the second admin after you.
So you can imagine, that... I have guys that want to join my WhatsApp group. I'm not a show-off guy. That's mm-hmm. not my life.
Yeah,
that's
true.
Not my lifestyle. But I have guys that come, they tell me they are fans, but just they're looking for girls.
Oh, so that's why they come to the group.
Yeah, I'm like, yo, you never post me, but like, yeah. It's all right. You know,
you should just take it easy as a guy.
Yeah, because you like, add him, cool. You know, and then most of the times I try to make sure, like, I check my statuses to see who posts me or am I still out there, you know?
Exactly.
Like,
or still is relevant. This group doing yeah. other things?
Yeah, you know.
But they could be in their DMs.
Let me ask, because we're both in the entertainment industry, and if one thing has been said, most artists in mm-hmm. this industry mm-hmm. feel we do not appreciate them. Do you feel? As for what you're doing, do you feel you are helping out in the music industry by pushing this music further? Do you feel like you're also a part?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Myself now, mm-hmm. people have given me confidence to really feel that.
Okay.
People themselves. I have people coming in and just commenting. They're like, you're a big pillar to our industry.
True.
And then I'm like,
okay.
That's a big comment. Okay.
It's a little and bit too heavy.
Yeah, I was kind of thinking of that, but like I'm like, okay, he just mentioned it.
Yeah.
And then someone else comes and is like, man, you made me like this song. Mm. He's like, you know, I have a guy that sang it's called Chris Banina sang the song is
those two cute twins.
Yeah, yeah. That I did that song, mm-hmm. But the song was trending in Kampala. Like I go everywhere, I see it trending. But like I kind of had my personal, I think because like they're liked by a lot of girls,
mm-hmm.
And I also I'm liked by a lot of girls.
So that kind of thing.
Do you like them back as well?
Yes, the
girls.
Yes,
I'm a chill guy. I like girls. Mm-hmm. I like girls, but you can't have all of them.
You can have a lump sum of them, my nigga. You can have a lump sum of them, not all of them, but a lump sum of them.
But you know, one thing is like if you follow me, mm-hmm. you can see that I'm very focused. If I can keep doing what I do takes time. Mm-hmm. So if I'm going to go look for those girls,
you won't be able to do what
no,
you do.
That's true. You can't produce.
That girl is like Derek wants you. I mean, he's going to admit it.
Let me finish this. So the guy Chris sent me the song to do it. I didn't do it. Mm-hmm. But one time, because I know that I do a good song, mm-hmm. I was like, you know what? I think I'm playing a fool. Mm-hmm. Why can't I do the song?
Okay.
And then I did the song. When I did the song, girls like it.
Yeah.
And then this guy, he's a very good guy. Mm-hmm. And then he came in my DM and he's like, Guy, Tomani Jones, he's in a ring, I'm over Kurachi Tonja Gala. I want to go never gamble, Wimber Wang, Runji, Winga Warugan, and Emma, confirm in the heat, Katin Teddy.
That's so sweet, though.
You know, so a comment like that, I'm like, okay, now what I'm doing.
It's worth it.
Is that some of the things that keep you inspired?
Exactly,
keep you going?
Exactly.
The appreciation?
Yeah. When I hear that, when someone comes and say that, it's like, Olimba Rwanga Rwanda hit, Nayengwa Oruganye, Neka Tinchitege Dembu Nuruli hit.
Okay.
That means like, yo, my job.
I just posted a picture of you on my social, and literally every guy, even those that hadn't texted me and hitting me up. I don't know what's happening, but anyway, I want to know. Probably I'm misinformed, or maybe I haven't watched the video. Have you done any John Black song?
Johnny Black?
Mm-hmm. Like that's, on a daily?
That's the guy I've done even
the
more.
The most?
Really? Yeah.
I think I need to look
for those videos. You need to
just go on the page. I need
to watch those ones,
yeah. Back forward. Move forward.
Genda
Kusos. Genda Kusos. DJ Bell, I want you to find me a song. And of course, I'm going to dedicate this moment right about now to Dora, my big sister. She's a very huge fan. She likes what you do on social media.
She's already screaming on social.
I want you to sing this song for her. Give me Boom Boom Party. I think that's the
boom
song.
Boom Party.
Yeah.
Hey!
Cindy. It's going to be a moment right about now. He's doing it live for the very first time on TV.
Hurry up. Give us a close-up.
You need to get this one. Dumba, when you're ready.
Whenever you're ready.
Bungo. Get the sauce on the sauce. Mhm. Sirum zanyo. Uva kumutwe paka kusos. Nkwete geke de banga. Kwesunze nga cheke mubanka. Ngamazi mutanka. Nkulu kutabwi wone taga. Mungo jure njina. Sura kutwani chendiko. Sura kutwani chendiko. Sura kutwani chendiko. Sura kutwani chendiko. I'ma call you daddy, I call you papi. Hey. Hey. I really like it. I'ma call you daddy, I call you papi. Yeah. I'ma see you track it, I know you like it. Boom party, on my body.
Take it down. I need to get, you know, your thoughts on the Ugandan music industry. From where it has come from, where it is right about now, given the lots of competition we have, lots of new artists coming through, where do you envision the industry in about 3 years from now?
In about 3 years from now, mm-hmm. I think with me, mm-hmm. if I'm still here, because
yeah.
I know my impact has been...
not being felt.
No, it's not where it is right now. Mm-hmm. With me, I'm planning something bigger that is going to bring something. I know what I'm doing is new for the industry, mm-hmm. but I know what I'm planning, what I have in mind. That's mm-hmm. why I'm here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What I have in mind will even make it bigger.
Okay.
But from where it's coming from, like I kind of feel like it was stagnant. Mm-hmm. There was a time when Radio and Weasel were the people like representing Uganda, mm-hmm. you know, and then at a time when Chameleon, Baby Cool, and Bobby Wine started doing this, people had hope. They're like, oh, music, Ugandan music is doing big. Yeah. That's when they had Mr. Nice in Tanzania, Nameless, Red Sun in Kenya, and all that. And then people felt like, but the Ugandans were like, you could feel like the vibe of Ugandans is a little
different.
A little bit higher than those. Mm. But I think it somewhere like, either Yasigara went to Wamu, and then the Tanzanians, the Tanzanians came, they went. Mm. The Nigerians came too, now the Ugandans were still there. Mm. And then to tell you the truth, Ugandans, they have a lot of talent.
Okay.
You can imagine how many kids that have, there was a song that I did, I had a song, someone sent me a song, I hear the song, I'm like, wow, this is a nice song. And then I looked for the guy. The guy had no Instagram. The guy had a YouTube video. Had like over three
subscribers.
Yeah.
Zero subscribers.
Like, and then, of course. And I'm like, this song, and the guy doesn't have, like, you know.
Yeah.
I made the song.
You were like, let me go to my car studio.
Yeah. I made the song, and I told people, I'm like, anybody that knows this guy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Munyonyi Mugamba grew Instagram. Mm. The guy now has Instagram. And then, you know, he has started, believing in himself. Mm, mm. And I think he's doing more. He's telling me he's meeting other people, which I think the question asked me if I'm impacting the industry. Mm. What is bigger than that?
That's shit. You know? Two last questions for me before you go. Do you think we should have more Dumbas like you to, you know, better our music industry?
One.
Or there should be only one Dumba?
If it was possible for somebody to be like me, we can have a million.
it's impossible.
I think it's impossible because someone to dedicate the time that I put in, someone to have my history that gives me what I do. Because like I'm telling you right now, people in Mbarara waiting for me. I do songs in Lunyankore.
Yeah.
Like, who's going to know Lunyankore, Swahili, Kinyarwanda, English, and then French and all that. Like, you know, that's my history. That's part of me that is blended.
Okay.
You cannot be me. Like, even if you can do Luganda and then you beat me, someone's going to say, Dumbayo, Aimba no Swahili, no Rusobola.
You did mention something that captured my mind when you said you have a lot of things you're planning. Are you organizing like a world tour where you're going to be singing covers? What are you going
to
be doing?
No, I was planning. I tried to talk to this to Alex Mahanj, but I think he was fixed. I was planning to get the names that I know are talents and then they are not known.
Yeah,
here and then to bring them on stage because my name can pull people.
Yeah, sure.
So when my name pulls those people, I bring these people because that's what they know. They know.
Them.
Yeah, I introduce them, and then when people when I introduce them, I know some people are going to know them.
Yeah.
And then if I have like I can have like 20, but if I have like 10 people, they come and then I present them to people. Let's say like a concert.
Yeah.
I present them to people. I'm like, guys. Like you saw what the songs, you had the songs, you had how they perform.
Yeah.
Then you guys, you can start from now.
Follow
them,
you know,
yeah, support
everything.
Them. Okay. And then I know they cannot, you can't miss three stars or four stars that can come from that.
From
kind of
that
like,
particular.
Yeah.
All right, thank you very much, Dumba, for coming through to the studio and really, really appreciate it. Unfortunately,
I'm going to do
we
my
have run out
deal,
of time.
Because I've seen people like mimicking him. I've seen like different celebrities. I'm going to go sit in
so you're targeting the men? But some of them give them to the guy. Hey, but ladies and gentlemen, DM him on Instagram. Your social media handles.
December, what do you
January.
January. Social media handles. Instagram.
Instagram is DUMB.A.
Okay.
DUMB.A. That's I have Facebook pages is like that too, but you get, come on Instagram.
Instagram is your,
yeah,
your way to
my
it. All right, there you have it. Now, Urban Today still continues, but we're going for a very short break. When we do get back, we kick it off straight with more music, entertainment, as well as the love letter right here on the show.